Hello, the game has started. It's me to go first. I've got a fantastic rack. I've got the blank, and I think, well, twining is certainly good, and I was thinking about entwine, but I prefer this. Twining for 76, and I like to get my opening play down quickly when I have a bingo and I'm playing online, in case opponent quits as a result of me dwelling too long on my opening move. But I'm fairly confident this is best or close to best. Now, no duplicates and balanced in the sense that there are two vowels and five consonants, but I'm not seeing a bingo here. I do have ing through an I, but the rest isn't giving up a bingo. I just noticed I had gunfire in column five, but that's not a double-double. And I probably don't have one. I do have the un prefix, but not seeing a double-double there. Scoring tiles in the F and the P don't go well together. U and G also unpleasant. It'll be hard to play all of those. I could play repune as a 6, leaving just the F. But I'm not seeing anywhere great for anything at the moment. Puring through the I would leave EF. Just one vowel next to a premium square, but I'd need two vowels to go after it. I do have that. I have FEU under twining, but that leaves four consonants, so surely not best. Opponent taking a while on their opening play. Do they also have a bingo? Always a bit galling when you open with a bingo, because that's a huge lift, and then it disappears if opponents got their own bingo. Now, I have literally just stepped off the train back from London, where I sat an exam in Mandarin, so my head is full of Chinese at the moment. Just getting my excuses in early in case I make any egregious howlers in this game. Opponent changes. Okay. So, well, that's good because it means I do have puring. But do I have something better? It would be nice to get rid of the F. Just looking at the possibility of playing fug. That doesn't work above or below. Let me try puring. 18 points, keeping EF. Vowels next to premium squares can be dangerous, but U next to a triple letter square, not massively so. Although it would be better to avoid that. Let me put this back. Is there really no way of getting rid of the F rather than the P? What about playing fungi? Rep a pretty decent rack leave, and I'm getting 18 points. I'm going with this. So having made an effort to retain the E, I now have it duplicated, but no other vowels. So I'm grateful for that. If I have a bingo, it would probably be through a floating vowel. Opponent takes out one of them for a handsome score. What about the U? No, not seeing a bingo there. So how to sort this rack out? Well, what about playing preen? 32 points, decent score. Okay, rack leave. Not offering anything massive. P, not a particularly bingo-y tile. And I'm covering the double letter square. So opponent will probably get an average score in row A. Am I going with this? I have an N for... Let me put this back, because I have an N for chin and a C for fungic. No CEN plays work in that spot. I'm going back to Preen for 32. Wow, I draw the second blank. Fantastic. Only one vowel, so I'm not bingoing this turn. But whenever you have one of the big scoring tiles, apart perhaps from the queue, you feel there's a possibility of a half-decent score. I'd like to get rid of the X, the W as well, and I have Wex on my rack. Oh, wow, opponent bingos. So my lead just 5 points. Opponent has, however, set up a nice spot for Wex. 41 points, and this is a good rack leave, although the board not particularly great for bingos. Can I do any better than Wex in this spot? 41 points is quite a lot to beat. No, I am going with this. Okay, I draw one vowel. Is that enough to bingo? IN could be a useful two-letter set. Wex takes an E, so the A is available as part of an EA word. Are there any? Great, just 33 points for opponent. Where are the floaters? There's the C of diacids, doesn't look helpful. There's the I of diacids. Gosh, that does look like it may be helpful. Quite a few tiles go in front of IN. T and W don't look useful. So the I and the IN look best. If a play began IN, it would get tripled. But do I have such a play? Don't think so. So let me consider this I, and I'll just look for any bingo which works. So tornadic, no. This rack plus an I. Centroid and doctrine, no. Inditor, nope. This rack plus an I. Nothing so far. This rack plus an I. No. I don't think there's anything beginning IN. What about IN in the middle? Pretty decent set of tiles. Duplicate N. Not seeing anything. So, is there anything I haven't considered? With the tiles IN, I do have non-credit. That doesn't have IN in order. 14 minutes on my clock. So I've got con. Let's see what this scores. 33 points, pretty decent. Not setting anything up for opponents. What would be the alternative? Probably playing crop. 24. Well, this is a lot more points. I can't extend it any further in either direction. Am I going with this? I am. I'm going with this. Still just the one vowel, but the blank means that this is a bingo-y rack. And there is this floating A with the X. So I have Thurston. Oh, an opponent blocks that wretched opponent. Cajun does not take anything. So, opponent blocks Thirsted. Cont not good. So I don't have any interwords. My blank would have to go next to con to make a word, or it begin I-N-E. But let me have a look at the floating O of cage on. That looks like the most likely. So I have throated. That places an E next to this double letter square. Do I have anything else? 12 minutes on my clock, 49 tiles in the bag. This rack plus an O, that's throated. This hotted not good. I don't think, but in any event, not as good as throated. So double O, nope. I think it is going to be throated. Red short is two R's, not two T's. No outwards. Great, I do have a bingo. Throated for 78. Wow, vowels come out to play now. Not a great rack. And my lead? Just 90 points. That could be eaten into massively if opponent's got a big row H play and the Z is still to come. Was there an alternative bingo to throated? Chin only takes an S. Still two S's unseen. One on my rack. Great, only 33. That could have been worse. And opponent provides a floating vowel just when I now do have vowels. So, how to sort this rack out? Very difficult, especially if I'm looking to score. Can't see anything through the P apart from goop. The Q's gone, so the U's are even less valuable than they might be. I can't score well off the J, 11 minutes on my clock. And I want to keep scoring because my lead is so slender. Very few spots on the board, and I also don't want to create spots for opponent to score easily. I'm still sore from the last game where opponent was banging in 40 and 50 point plays. I don't have an A for a bed. Look at this, seven A's to come. So is there anywhere for just OU? No, not here. Ot isn't good. I could play up go, which has... Well, I was going to say it stops opponent scoring in row A, but it does create this spot under the O where the K could go with rock. However, this rack leave is nice and goes well with the T. I've got the out prefix. I don't think up go has got an anagram. 7 points is wretched. Absolutely wretched. But where is better? Let me put it back in case there's something better. Just notice that oboe is good. Icon is good. I don't have an I. I'm short on time. I'm going with up go for 7. Wow, I draw A's, and although I have an A for a bed, up go has taken out the W from OW. Just wondering if I had a bingo through the T, close to out of sight, but the A would need to be an I. Still a lot of vowels to come, but there was a shortage earlier on. Opponent changes, fantastic. Does that give me an opportunity to start scoring again? Yeah, yes, it does. No, it doesn't, but it does give me an opportunity to sort my rack out in one. Hour for 11, providing nothing for opponent, keeping a decent rack, which could survive a single A. Am I missing a better spot for hour? I don't think so. Yeah, I am going with this. Wow, I draw two A's and an R, which is good. Do I have anything with a T? No. Wow, floating G. I don't think I considered that earlier, but I'm not seeing anything. 25 for opponent. What about this V? No, but it does provide me the opportunity of playing Avo. My lead only 56 points. I have Aerosat on my rack. Am I confident that there are no seven-letter lanes on the board? Well, there's row J if the S were in second place. Does Aerosat make anything with a T? Don't think so. So I was thinking of Avo here, which doesn't create a lane. Still two S's to come. I don't think I'd finished looking at the floaters. This rack plus an L. No, and the E doesn't look useful. So have a look at this. Look at this. Well, the score's rubbish, but look at this rack leave. It's incredibly good. It goes okay with the T. It goes okay with E and L. It's pretty vulnerable in the sense that the board isn't awash with bingo lanes. It goes well with the G, but this maximizes my chances of bingoing, and Avo provides nothing for opponent. I am creating a great seven-letter lane, which has got to benefit me more than opponent. If opponent plays in that spot, they'll be providing floaters. I'm going with this. So, not a great pick. I was looking to bingo, and I've drawn the Z. So, I don't think Starrett takes an A. I'm not going to check that. It would play in column three. I don't have a seven here. Where can I play the Z for a good score? I've got Tsar in column 14, but with so many A's and E's to come, that would be madness. Zin is good, but I do want to play off the A as well. I've got Zia in row D. But again, that has the demerit of, well, keeping two A's and burning my E. But it does score quite well. 36 points. Maybe worth doing. I have Tsars and Avos. 24 for opponent. Does the L give me an? Did I have lazarettes? That may be double TE, but in any event, Pode are not good, so that's been blocked. Opponents. Wow. The L is nice. If I could play off just ZA somewhere, then my rack would be good. But is there anywhere for ZA? What about a play ending ZI? Not seeing one. This is a really tricky position to be in. 5 minutes on my clock, still 26 tiles to come. How mad is this? Because it's 28 points, but what goes after Uta? Only an S. So a lot of the time, opponent can just stick a single letter after Z for only 30 points, which is an average score. And I'm keeping the best possible Rackley with a fantastic floater in the L, the G and the T. And 28 points is pretty decent for Tsar. Yeah. Okay, I am going with this. And I draw two vowels, but I have earliest through the L. Fantastic. What do I have through the T? I have treaties. I am bingoing, I think. Opponent could have a play ending in L, which scuppers both. But we'll just have to wait and see. I do have ZE, should that happen, for 33 points and an amazing rack leave. I have eateries down from the E. I am bingoing. Fantastic. That does place an S in last place. Not ideal for row O. My lead at the moment is a bingo. How much is opponent going to score? A's, E's and O's can go after the Z. And even if they extend that with an S, they're not getting that much more. And I would certainly prefer opponent to make a two-letter Z play than to bingo. So, what's my best bingo? Do I have anything beginning I-N? That would need an E or an I. No, not seeing anything. I have an I for going in front of icon. For going in front of con, rather. Creating icon. Close to wisteria, but it's weariest with this set. That doesn't work. I have iterates through the T, which is interesting. Great, just 33 points. I have iterates, which doesn't open row O. Interesting. Let me see what that scores. This is 70. This is 77. I'm going for the extra 7 points because I think if opponent bingos, they're not guaranteed to win. I don't think it hugely affects my winning prospects. And partly because if they do bingo in row O, they may well have been able to bingo if I had played iterates. So I am going with eateries for 77. Great. For 7 random tiles, this is pretty good. I've got a nice scoring tile in the K and a balance of vowels and consonants. And with regards to the K, I've got KA in column 10, getting the K tripled twice. I've also got the K for going under the O of up go. So I do have rock in that spot, which is not bad. It's better than KA because it's splitting up the duplicate O. Do I have any 5-letter plays ending R? Okay, let me stop that look because opponent has played only 22 points, which is fantastic. And they've opened access to row O. What do I have in row O? Nothing goes after V, so I can only hook the E, where I can place R and A. And I'd like to play the K for score. Wow, what do I have? 3 minutes on my clock. Oh, I was going to say I had Kago. I don't. That doesn't end in E or R. What about playing neither and just piling on the points? And this is a decent 5-letter set. I'm not going to get into any trouble with this. Did I really have nothing ending E or R, A or R rather? Well, I do. I have okra.26 points. Let me count the remaining vowels. 6 out of 19, vowel dry. I don't like this rack leave. My lead is 100 points before I do anything. I don't think okra stops opponent from bingoing. They could just bingo in row N, so I'm just reducing the score slightly. And what if opponent doesn't have a bingo? They'll probably play something in row O, which can't put a scoring tile on a double letter square, so that's probably going to be an average score. I'm going with rock. So, not a million miles away from a bingo. Wow, I have wag moi, but acorn not good. I don't think there's a seven here. It's not far off a bingo, but I'm not seeing anything with the T. What about the G? Great, just 23 points, and opponent burns five tiles. So that is a good outcome. Do I have a bingo? 1 minute on my clock, good grief. Not much time for looking. Not that I can see. Five tiles in the bag. I don't think opponent's got a bingo. What about emptying the bag and getting 30 points, 478? This guarantees the win, and I am short on time. Let me put this back. I haven't considered L and Y. Not seeing anything with the L. G no longer exists. Y. And should I be playing four tiles? Well, I'm just short on time, so I'm going with Romage 430. Oh, which of course takes an F in front. And I haven't drawn that, but I have drawn quite well. I have six letters plays on my rack. Do I have anything playable through the L? I have retiled. Great. That gives me an out there. I have tedia and re-edit on my rack. Great. Retiled remains available. 40 seconds on the clock. And yeah, I have re-edit here for even more. I have dieter for even more than that. Dumb not good. So no. Let me revert. Tiered for 29. Dumb is good in Chinese, I think. So that would explain that. So, and the final score. 366 for opponent, 521 for me, a winning margin of 156, 155 points, so a huge, huge win. Let's see what I missed. Wow, what a great game. Always great fun to get over 500 points, but it didn't feel like a runaway game all the way through, even though I opened with this rack. And I played Twining for 76, that was the highest scoring play. Opponent less blessed with three eyes, changes. Untwining for 33. Always nice to see extensions, but not necessarily the best plays. So I play Fungi for 18, keeping PER. Does F and G negate this by 15 points? I don't think so, but these moves aren't a million miles apart. Opponent's rack. Plays Chi for 44. Phew, no miss bingo here. And I play Preen for 32. Great spot by opponent of Diacids. And now just 5 points between us. I play Wex for 41. Opponent's rack plays Ob. Now, phew, no miss bingo here. And Con was my play and nothing obviously better. This was the only play over 30. Opponent plays Cajon. And I play Throated. And Hotted was good, but scored less, a lot less. Opponent's rack plays Valley. And now things got a bit grim and a bit tight. Still 39 tiles in the bag. And my lead only about a bingo. So I play up Go for 7. I could have played Vogue. Yeah, Vogue takes a number of hooks and provides floaters, but it does sort the rack out and scores a lot more than up Go. But this is a tight board, so up Go does have some merit. Horrible rack for opponent. Doesn't play changes. Sojar, that's nice. Through the J, burning the S. What do? I play Hour for 11, keeping toes. Yeah, I like my play. I do have a lead, and rack leaves are important. I know I can't always find the best play, but the more balanced and higher value my rack leave is, the better able I feel to maintain a lead. Opponent plays AY. I have Aerosat, nowhere for it. Very few scores over 20, and again, I sacrifice points to leave a decent rack leave. Opponent plays Piley, and although I kept an excellent five-letter set, I've drawn the Z. No bingo. Sturetz doesn't take an A. So I play Tsar for 28. Yeah, and I like that play. I could have got 8 more points, but burning the E, keeping duplicate A. And Tsar not massively dangerous despite appearances. So opponent plays just ZE for 33 points, an average score. And I have a whole choice of bingos, which I don't think I would have had if I had played that move for eight fewer more points. So Eatery scores most, that's what I played. And now my lead is 110, so pretty healthy. No bingo for opponent. Plays Evohi, opening a lane. Grok, B3. Oh, I could have just stuck a G on the beginning of Rock. It doesn't get doubled, but it does play off one more tile and score more, so I should have done that. Instead, I played Rock. Opponent plays Mail. And now just 5 tiles in the bag. I play Romage for 30. Nothing scores more. Opponent plays Butt. Could have got 40 by sticking the F on the end of Romage with Serfs. But they don't see it or play it. And now finally, L4. Oh, dumb is good. Okay, that's not just a Chinese word. It's a 3-letter English word, and therefore one I should have known. But I didn't play that. I played Tiered for 2 fewer points. So, what an absolutely cracking game. Fantastic start with a bingo and the blank, and I was ahead throughout, but at times opponent got close, I think, to within 4 points after Diacids, and then later on was just 50 points away. But I had a couple of near bingo racks and sacrificed points to keep a good rack leave, and that paid off when I was able to play Eateries and then had a big lead that I was able to hang on to. So many congratulations or thanks to opponent for a good battle. Washiwang Nishihuan Guankan Nachang Bisai Shihuan Pinglun Ding Yue, Shatsu Zai Jian. Another language butchered.